Nwankwo, and I represent Orumba North and Orumba South Federal Constituency, Mr. Speaker, from Anambra State. Mr. Speaker, I'm rising to support this motion because it is a wake-up call. Mr. Speaker, it's a wake-up call because, for once, we should be mindful of the impute that goes into the mindset of our children. Mr. Speaker, you know that there is a theorem in science that says that action and reaction is equal and opposite. What you impute is what outputs. If we should build a Nigeria of tomorrow, we should build a very dedicated young mind, knowledgeable about their country. There should be a cord connecting the country and every child. To me, Mr. Speaker, that is the threshold of this motion, which says that civic education should be taken seriously. But more importantly, Mr. Speaker, my friend Benila said this House should uphold the supremacy of the Constitution as a prayer. It shouldn't be, it's not a prayer, it's given. That is why we are here, to uphold the principles, content, spirit, and words of the Constitution. And the Constitution has already said that there is choice as to religion. If you make both religious education compulsory for children, for instance, you tell one child that in this book, this person is a prophet. In the other book, this person is son of God. You get what I mean? The child will be confused. This motion is very important. It's a call for us to look into the content of our curriculum. And I think that we should be able to revolutionize our curriculum design. We should update our curriculum design. We should align our curriculum design to national objectives. We should make religion our curriculum design to be very trendy, innovative, and capable of producing children that will take over from us tomorrow. Mr. Speaker, I so submit.